So hello and welcome to video 16 of the series. Today we want to have a look at the graphical user interface, and we want to. The goal for today is just to have some kind of hello world to get the graphical user interface displayed. Some very basic things. So what I want to use is okay. Let's move that here. Is a GTK, so which are the GObject introspection bindings to GTK. The thing is, this is also part of the stackage snapshot, of the long-term snapshot, and it's the one that's in the moment one of the best maintained graphical user interfaces bindings for Haskell. There are other ones. I used also the GTK3 binding and also the old GTK2 binding. They are also quite good and they're okay, but not that maintained anymore. So it's currently advised that you use this GTK. So you see here different versions, and I have the version 3.0.37 selected, because the other ones are for GTK4, and I will go to GTK3. GTK4 is far too new to actually use it for something. And so first thing first, I hate it when Visual Studio does this. Okay. So let's add it first to, we will add it directly in the executable. Let's say it like this. And there is also a library, not git, hs, which provides some convenience function, which we will later use. So if you compile it now, GTK takes quite a long time to compile, so you can do this in the background. I've already done this, so basically it should, I hope it should, no. Recompiling, yeah. Let's see if it compiles GTK. I don't think so. Okay, so let's first create the user interface, and for this I will use Glade. So Glade is a little bit controversial. It's the GUI builder for GTK, and it has some quite severe problems, and people generally don't like it that much. It's okay for basic usage. If you do certain things, it can do things wrong and then mess things up. If I have an application with 800 widgets, I don't want to lay them out all by code. I want to have an immediate feedback how it could look like on the screen. So I've already fired up Glade. So first I want to have, let's quickly start. Let's create a new one. And we will start with a GTK application window. Yeah, and so we get this. Let's make it a little bit bigger. Basically, we should then have a width and a size request. Let's say 1000 by 800 or something like that. 8000 is a little bit much. Okay, and so if you don't know how GTK layouting works, you often work with some layouting classes, containers, the most basic one is a box. So I just want to add a box. So we have now three fields, vertical fields. And basically what I want to have three structures, three main areas. You have a menu bar, which we won't use that much. But it could be used for extensions later. In the middle, the main display, and then at the bottom, a message display for the log messages. So what I want to do now is remove one, so that we have only two areas. And then first thing is we add this menu bar. Yeah, you see, then you have the file menu, edit menu, and so on. We won't use much of them currently, only the quit thing. And then we have the main area. And for the main area, why I have not another field in the box is because I want to use this paint. Where is it? Pain. Yeah. So pain is basically you can shift the difference with the mouse. So let's go to the packing page and expand that. So then it's expanded, and then you see here's the division between a small and a bigger one. And I also want to do this vertical. And then let's say the position is something like that, maybe. Yeah, so we have then the log messages down here, and on the upper half we have then the displays. So let's add first for the log messages. We have to also some kind of tabular form for the log messages. So this would be a tree view in GTK. And to add a tree view, you need first a scrolled window so that you can scroll within the tree view. Otherwise, it won't do that. And then we have a tree view, GTK tree view, yes, and we add it here. And this tree view, we give a name, tree view log messages. Okay, so I want to have two pages, one for the TM packets and one for the parameters, maybe with a graphical display. So let's add a notebook and remove the third page. So we have page one, which is then for the TM packets, page two for parameters, yes. And I want to, so if you then want to switch, you have this field here, edit page, so you can switch between pages. And then we have, well, we can also lay out here things. So I want to have a main display, scrolling, as a table left outside and for the packet header information, and on the right side for the packet detail information, some fields maybe. So let's do again a box. Let's make this horizontal field with this two, and then again the scrolled window for the tree view. Let's make the scrolled window expand, add a tree view. Here let's add also a box. This is a vertical box, yes. Let's make it two fields, maybe also expand it a little bit, then add a frame. This is now, this frame is just a placeholder for now. And then in the lower part, there's also a table, so a scrolled window and scrolled window. Let's expand the scrolled window and also display a tree view. Right, so let's then just give this label a little bit more descriptive name, make it bold. Okay. And then for now, I will just add a placeholder label, which doesn't do anything. It's just there for a placeholder thing. And then let's go to the second page. And the second page is still empty. And for now, I will just place a GTK drawing area there. And then let's switch back here. Do we have to do something else? No. I think that's enough for now. Save as. Let's create here a new directory called data files, data for the data files, and let's new interface.ui, it's a clean file, save it there. Okay, so let's have a look if we see it here. Load, we have data here. And this is an XML file, as you see. Okay, so next thing is how to get that into the program so that the code can load the builder file and display it. So of course, first we need to initialize GTK. So we will need import GTK is GTK. So the name is quite easy to remember. And then we probably, after this, so this is still command line processing. And so we want to start the graphical user interface afterwards. So let's see. And let's start. Let's see what GHCID says. Probably if I got the parameter or something. Oh yeah, it's I couldn't match. Maybe list of texts. Just pass in nothing. And ambiguous occurrence of main. Then we have to import it qualified. Okay. And I do notation discards. We don't remember the result. And then for now, very quickly, just before, instead of running the chains, we commented out and calling GTK main. Right. Okay. So this initializes GTK and runs the GTK main loop. The thing with the GTK main loop is it has to run in the main thread, or at least in a bounded thread. And so we run it in main directly. And all other things need them to run in different threads, if they should run in different threads, yeah, which is the case in our application. So basically this should start, and now we need to, of course, somehow load the file. And the thing is, for this glade file, there are several functions how you can import the data and then display them. I just want to quickly show the window so that we see we have some kind of hello world. And so we need to either load this from a file, or we could include the file directly into the executable with some example, the file embed library in Haskell, which I also did for other applications. But we can also use the standard GTK mechanism for this, which is resources. And I want to do that. So the thing is, you define a resources file, and I have already one created here. This is an XML file, which is a G resources, and then a list of resources. And in this case, it's a file preprocess with XML strip blanks, and it's in data, and it's called interface UI. Let's see. Yeah, that's right. And then we have a prefix, which is the resources have some kind of directory structure. So let's make it like this. And then there is a GTK functionality, a binary, which compiles then this down to a C file. I have also created a bash file, which calls glib compile resources, which does this. The source directory generated, the target is CSRC, so we probably need to generate it, C stores, yes. And it will create a resources.c file out of this of the files contained in resources.xml. And there you can also put in, for example, graphics like PNGs, SVGs, icons, all other data files that should be compiled into the program. And so let's just try this create resources. It runs, and then basically we should have a CSC file, yes, and then we have a C file, and you see this is now created from this binary, so we have some kind of data, yeah, a lot of data and some functions to access this. So the only thing we need to do in main then again, in the cabal file, is then we have to specify the directory. So we have here HS source tiers is for the Haskell files, and then we have C sources, C source resources.c. So to load this, and basically that should be it. Let's try at least if it's compiled, it compiles. Okay, yeah, we have these undefined things because not used things because we now don't call them. And for now it looks good. Okay, so let's just very quickly get something up and running. So in source exe, let's create a new folder called GUI, and in the GUI, let's create a new, a new file, main window.hs. So, GUI main window. Geo import GTK. Let's define just a data structure, and so everything we need to access later in the program somewhere, the widgets from GTK or something other stuff we need to access later, we should put into this data structure. And for current, this is just, let's call this a window, which is an GTK application window, since we created an application window in Glade. And for now, that's it. Let's also export this. And for here, I don't, for this module, I don't export the data constructor and the fields. So just the type. And then init main window, which takes, well, we run in mono.io, of course, and then it takes a GTK builder, probably, and should return an IO, main window, right, I think like that, builder. And then what we do is window is undefined for now. Pure GUI. Let's add this to the cabal file. And this is then a case for other modules. So GUI main window, and let's call GCID again. And yeah, okay. So we have to do something with the builder, get out the main window from the, we haven't named it. Okay, that's what, this is also bad. So this GTK application window, we need a name for it. So let's simply call this main window, save the file. And after we save the file, we have to, mono.iom from the context mono.iom. It's not IO, it's mmonad. Your builder not used. Okay, this compiles at least for now. So in main, then we need to somehow create or initialize the builder. And I will quickly cheat how I did this. Actually, I did it like this. Did we already do this here? So, yeah, that's fine for now. Let's create the builder here. Because if you have multiple windows to initialize or multiple things where you need to pass the builder, it makes sense to pass it in, but we have only this main window here. So let's say builder, and this is then builder new from resource. So it should load this from this resource from this C file. And we have specified this path, as you remember here, this prefix first, and then in data interface.ui. So let's go here, GUI data interface.ui. And then we should get a builder. And then first, we want to get the window out. This is a little bit more complicated, so we'll use a helper function. And set the window as the field, and then we pass it out. And now we need a helper function. So the thing is, this was in GTK 2HS, so the old GTK bindings, this was a little bit easier. So we need a helper function, and I just copied that from what I tried and from another project. So and this helper function looks like this. this is a get object function, which is a funny type signature. So it gets the builder, it gets the text, so the widget which we want to have, then some kind of point. This is a basically a constructor. So which type to cast to? So from this, you get the G object, I think, out of the builder file, and then you have to cast it to the right widget. And if you don't, you get a nothing. Yeah. So basically, this calls builder get object out of this, and then you get a nothing or a just, and a nothing we abort with error, which is okay, because if you can't load the user interface, then you can't start the application. And the same is then if we have this, then we cast this to the constructor given here, and if the cast cannot succeed, then we also fail the application. So basically, this should then be, we get this object from the builder with the name main window in our case, and cast this to an application window, and that's basically the usage of the builder. So that should be quite easy. Then we have, okay, it you needs t unpack. Yep, so import qualified view. Let's see if this works. T unpick, yes. Yeah, no code actions available, sorry. Text st. Right, compiles. What does it say here? Cannot load. Yeah, that's why GHCAD is up to date, but Haskell language server not. So, and then we need to call a show all probably, because the widget will otherwise not be shown. Yes. And also we need to set, this is also important, on widget destroy the window. Main quit. So when the window is destroyed, we should quit the application. Otherwise, the window would be destroyed, but the application would keep running. So we don't want that. So when the window is destroyed, we should call main quit, and which basically terminates the main loop of GTK. And then also GTK widget show all everything that's in the window. So we don't need the parentheses here. And then return the GUI. So let's give it a quick go of these compiles. Compiles. Let's see. And we forgot something. It's always the same. Of course, we need to call this function. So. So we need to init the main window before we start the main loop, yeah, because otherwise it won't work. And so let's also get this main window structure out so that we can refer to it later. Maybe possibly if we then have to pass some data from the conduit chains to the user interface, we need to pass it down to the run chains somewhere. That's why we pull it out, even if it's not used yet. Init main window, and we need to import GUI main window. And let's run again. Linking, running. Could not find main window in glade file. Yeah, because we haven't created the resources again. I said we should not. No, I didn't say it. But every time you change the glade file, you have to rerun this this bash script. Otherwise, the changes won't be in the C file, and the C file will be compiled in. So, whoop, and we have a window, and we can switch between, and this is the paint view, so we can change the sizes if you like. We have the menus, even if they don't do anything now. But yes, so we have Hello World as a graphical user interface. And maybe we should also make this a little bit smaller. Anyway, okay, so and it calls main quit, and we have logging. Okay, very good. So that was the Hello World. Thanks a lot for watching. Next time we will go into more details and how to really display things.